Hello my friends of Guattari Labs, welcome to the second part of this tutorial of modeling mixing zones of effluents into the sea. Okay, so this time what we are going to do is let me show you what we are going to do. So in the first part you have done a geometry that is this mesh 1 UMV, that is a mesh. Okay, so and then right now you are going to construct the mixing zone. You are going to build your model based on this geometry. Okay, so for this we are going to use OpenFOAM for Windows. So actually OpenFOAM for Windows is here. This is maybe an old version, but this is an old version maybe from 4 months ago. Right now it's in the version 18.04. okay, but it works in this one and it should work in the newest. Okay, so we open this and it will guide you to a special folder that we are going to discuss later. Okay, so here maybe for your OpenFOAM installation this is empty, but for me I have already developed some model, so I'm going to create a new folder, and this new folder will be effluent mixing zone. Okay, this will be my working folder. Okay, so and then I change. Okay, here it's empty as you have seen, but right now we are going to list the whole tutorials available for the solver intermixing foam. Foam tutorials, intermixing foam is from multiphase, and is intermixing foam, and then on laminar conditions, because actually on the library is on laminar only, yeah, but I think that you can set up for turbulent conditions as well. And here we have the down break. Okay, so say down break is actually a tutorial that you can run by your own. Yep, and this is like the basic intermixing foam tutorial. Okay, so okay, what we are going to do is that we are going to clear first, and then we are going to copy the whole files of this tutorial to here. And then and we want to copy with folder, so that's why I set up cp-dash. Okay, so actually here you have the zero, the alt clean, the constant, and the system. Okay, great. So where are we now? We are in SIG drive C OpenFOAM 18.2 user run zone. And where is it exactly on our hard drive? In our hard drive is C OpenFOAM user run. So if you see OpenFOAM 18.2 user dev run, and this is the effluent mixing zone. Okay, great. So first of all, what we are going to do is we are going to, I prefer to cut it and to put it here and to change it this to air. Other is actually the effluent, and this is water. Okay, great. So I use Notepad, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this because this is set up for the tutorial, and I'm going to change this to the geometry and to the patches of my of the model of the mixing zone model on the scene. Okay, so and then for this I have already done it, so I okay, great. So okay, first this is the inlet. This is the outlet. This is the effluent. Effluent. Why not? And then I copy the effluent to the model wall. You will have it on the description of this tutorial. However, I strongly recommend that you type it because you get a better feeling of what is going on here. Otherwise, it's kind of it's not a black box, but it can. It seems as a model wall. Yeah, and this everything here is zero grain. So inlet, outlet, effluent, model wall, atmosphere, and default, yeah, is zero grain. Okay, save. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to work with the effluent. Yep. On the effluent will be as well, I have to change this inlet. Outlet effluent, I have to copy always the effluent. Ah, for this tutorial I have to copy the effluent. Model wall. Okay, great. And this will be inlet, outlet, inlet value, uniform, because actually the effluent is not coming through the no, there is no effluent through the in the on the C circulation, only on the effluent channel value. That's great. So I can type this, and then as well in the outlet. The outlet can have some other, yeah, but the size of the effluent is actually not do not reach the other. You will see this in the simulation. Okay, the effluent is actually one here because this is width. Okay, model wall is zero gradient, atmosphere is in outlet, inlet, outlet. Okay, that should work. Once again, inlet, inlet, 1, 0 gradient. Okay, great. So then we have to type the initial condition for water. Okay. And then for water, and for water we have as well, for this tutorial we have inlet, outlet, atmos, no, this is effluent, and this is mother wall. Yeah, and here will be the effluent, will be full of water. No, the inlet will be full of water. The outlet at the beginning do not have water. The effluent as well has no water, has effluent, mother wall, and the inlet outlet. Okay, that's it. That should work. Save, always save. Okay, great. So these are the original files, and then from this, Control C, Control V. Okay. Then what we are going to do is that we are going to work. We are going to work with the velocity and with the pressure. So here, velocity. Okay. In the internal field, there is some flow current. Okay, so what does it mean? So there is some sea circulation. Yep, and this sea circulation is from the beginning of the model. Water is moving. Okay, so that's why we have this internal field, and as well on the inlet, more water is coming. Fixed value uniform. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry, as I told you, inlet, outlet, effluent, and then I copy this as mother wall. The outlet is actually zero gradient. The outlet is set up that it's almost like every water that reaches the outlet, it will leave the model, and then flow rate, inlet velocity. Mm-hmm. Volumetric flow rate constant 0.04. And then value uniform, so we are, what do I say is that there is a constant flow rate, so this constant flow rate will be applied on the face, on the edge. Okay, mother wall is no sleep. And atmosphere in this is asleep. And the default faces are empty. Okay, save. Then what we are going to do now is that we are going to set up the pressure initial conditions. Okay, first change, so this is inlet, outlet, this is inlet, outlet, effluent, and this is, ah no, sorry, actually I have to copy the effluent to motherboard. So so actually this will be zero gradient, this will be total pressure, and the rest will be zero gradient as well. Zero gradient, zero gradient, zero gradient. This is empty, total pressure. Okay, that's right. Safe. Okay, that's amazing. Okay, great. So we have already, well, we have already all files for the zero, so the initial conditions. Okay, I'm happy for this, and then we go to constant. Okay, see, for the initial example it's actually a 2D model, and this is a 3D model, where in the 2D model the gravity was on the negative direction of the y-axis, and right now is on the negative direction of the z-axis. So it's here. Okay, and then on transport properties you have that both, that the three are Newtonian. What does it mean that they are Newtonians? It means that the viscosity is constant. However, you see the effluent has a higher density than the water, and for our case the effluent do not have this. So in the tutorial actually it had this, but we are going to say that the effluent and our water are exactly the same. Okay, of the same density, and we are working on laminar. Okay, then we go to system. We don't need the block mesh because we are going to create the mesh from the UMV, from the geometry that we have done, the mesh geometry that we have done in Salome. So, and since we are working in Windows, also, we are not going to do some parallelization of the servers. So I delete it, and here in Control D, yep, I have run this, so, and I know that in 180 seconds the model will reach somehow a steady state. Yeah, and I want to write every result every 3 seconds. Yep, that's it. Save. Okay, and in set field digs, we are going to say that everything is with water at the beginning, And here we have a box to cell that is the effluent channel that will have some effluent, and this channel is defined by these two points. Yep, okay, save. Okay, and that should be everything. Okay, right now you are ready to run your model. Okay, and how do you run your model? First you set ls, and then you're going to see, well, you're going to see the files that you have modified, but first we are going to set ideas UMB to foam. It doesn't matter if it comes with the X or not. And then okay, we need the mesh here. And in order to get the mesh, we are going to this mesh one, control C, and then I'm going to copy this. You will have all of these files on the description of the video. Okay, here I have the mesh, so I have, say, ls, okay, and then if I say ideas UMB mesh one, and they say okay, it has recognized the atmosphere, the effluent, the effluent, and the model path, and so on. Please read all of this. Okay, and then I'm going to set the fields, because I know that some parts are filled with, some parts will be filled with water, and some part will be filled with effluent. And then I do a check if the mesh is okay. Okay, the mesh is okay, and then I am ready to run the model intermixing foam. Okay, and then I have a problem, and it say P0. Okay, I have to go to zero, I have to go to ProHG. Okay, and it say something has happened. Okay, so I go to here and say, okay. And they say a value was not defined at the outlet. So they say P0 Sorry. This is not value, this is P0. Save it once again. Okay, I have another problem. Why not? Here on the velocity. Okay. On the line. Here I do not have this. Okay. Okay, save, and once again, Okay, that was it. Okay, do not worry, because always you will find this, because it matters that you, if you haven't put a comma or a point or something like that, it won't run. But it is like this. Okay, the only thing that will make you or keep you from making this, keeping you out from making these errors, is actually that you do practice more, okay? And with practice you will have a better training and a better management of what of your models and the quality and so. Okay, so it's running, and let me show you. So actually it has already run 24 seconds. It will run for 180 seconds. Actually, we are not going to wait for this. Yep. So in the next part of the tutorial, what we are going to do is that we are going to see the results and to create another one, because actually this is a mixing zone, and so we are going to set up a species. Okay, so we have a component in of our water, and this water will have some, this water will have, for example, sulfates, and we want to see how the sulfates is being diluted by the sea current, okay? Or chemical oxygen demand, or another component, okay? Or nitrates as well. Okay, so see you in the coming tutorial, and have a great day. Bye bye.